Bizzibox's expert information on cupping. What is cupping?
Cupping is a form of treatment that is used, it was referred to as an adjunctive treatment to acupuncture. Something that you use in addition to, although you could use it on its own. It's often used for pain, or it can be used for what we would call an acute invasion, like something like a cold or flu or something of that sort. It's little, usually glass cups, perhaps that sort of size, or that kind of size, and they're put onto the skin and they form a suction, and they're left there perhaps for 10-15 minutes, and quite often you're left with a mark on the skin. I don't know if you saw recently in the press Gwyneth Paltrow wandering about with cupping marks all over her back.
What does cupping treat?
Cupping treats chronic pain, acute pain, colds, flus, anything where you've got an accumulation of stuck energy on the surface of the body. It will also treat sprains and strains. So for example, if you've played football and you've got very stiff muscles, maybe it rained and you got cold, cupping would be a great way to deal with that.
Who are the best candidates for cupping?
The best candidates for cupping are probably people who are young and strong. You're less likely to do cupping on an elderly patient. But having said that, I would think that probably in an average practice, 75% of the patients would be suitable for cupping at some point or another.
Who should avoid cupping?
Normally people don't go for cupping treatment on its own. Cupping is usually used as part of an acupuncture treatment, and as such, there isn't anybody who should avoid cupping, but there are people who perhaps their practitioner will not suggest cupping is appropriate.
What happens when I go for cupping treatment?
Most likely you won't see what happens actually. Very often cupping happens on the back. The practitioner takes the cup, and usually there are two forms in which this can be done. Either you can take the oxygen out of it by a burning taper, and then you put it onto the skin. Once there is no oxygen in it, it sucks. It sort of goes, it makes a partial vacuum and sucks the skin up slightly into a bit of a dome inside the cup. Another way of doing it, which is quite acceptable, is some people have a cup that they can pump. It pumps to make a partial vacuum. So either is fine.
What does cupping feel like?
Cupping feels like, almost like massage on a muscle that's tense. It's really a nice feeling.
Is cupping painful?
Cupping's not painful. It feels like if you have a tense muscle and you lean on it, you know that feeling. It's really, really a welcome feeling, isn't it? Even though it might be a bit uncomfortable, you think, great, more of that. It's like that.
How many cupping treatments will I need?
It very much depends on the condition. Usually cupping is used in quite an acute condition, so often it will be used on a single occasion for a particular pain. On the other hand, you might use it for something like arthritis, in which case you might use it again and again. It's usually part of another treatment.
Does cupping leave marks?
Cupping, you should be aware, leaves marks on the skin. And generally, of course, this isn't a problem, but if you're a lady who's going to go out to a ball, for example, and you're going to wear a nice low-neck dress and you've got a load of cupping marks that look like you've been attacked by a giant octopus, it's not good.
When will I see results from cupping?
Cupping's usually a really quick treatment in terms of seeing results. Generally speaking, the result is within a day, 2 days, maybe immediately. Quite often it's immediate. quite often the patient gets up from the couch and they are immediately better.
Who can perform cupping treatments?
Anybody can perform cupping because, like acupuncture, it's not regulated in this country at the moment. But I would recommend that you go to somebody who's trained, and almost always cupping is done in conjunction with acupuncture. So you would be looking for an acupuncturist. So look on the web for the British Acupuncture Council.
What should I look for when choosing a cupping practitioner?
You're really looking for the same thing as you would look for with an acupuncturist. Because the two treatments go together, you're looking for somebody who's been trained in traditional Chinese medicine, who's probably got a degree in acupuncture, and who's got membership of a professional body.
What precautions should I be aware of?
The only precautions that you should be aware of relate to whether or not your practitioner works with a code of safe practice. It's obviously important to make sure that cups are properly looked after, properly cleaned after use. Providing you're working with somebody who works to a code of safe practice, you've got no problem with that. So look on the web for the British Acupuncture Council and you'll be fine.
How much do cupping treatments usually cost?
Cupping treatment is not usually offered independently of acupuncture. So the cost of it will be incorporated into the acupuncture treatment. You wouldn't normally expect to pay extra.
www.bizzibox.com